Today, we're doing shrimp.
Barbecue style.
We're firing up the grill and then slathering on some homemade barbecue sauce.
Oh, yeah. Now, that's how we do it. Southern style.
That is right.
or our Aussie friends, a little shrimp on the Bobby.
On the Bobby. That's what we're going to do. I mean, in honor of the Barbie movie. Yeah. No, that's silly. Anyway, so stupid. I'm Chris.
And I'm Wesley.
My Barbie loon.
It's like, how did you go from there?
It was a bad segue. And anyway, so let's get onto more important stuff, which is barbecue
sauce.
Shrimp. Yeah, and shrimp sauce.
And the shrimp.
Wow, we're all over the place. Okay, I'm gonna get started. So first of all, we're gonna make the sauce. He's right. So I've got my cast iron skillet that I've got a couple tablespoons of olive oil heated up, and I'm to that gonna add a half an onion. So what we're making is this is just a classic easy barbecue sauce. It's really good.
It's my favorite.
I am making half the amount that the recipe normally calls for. So when you look at that recipe, if you want to do this, just cut it in half or make it because it makes extra barbecue sauce.
We always have it in the fridge.
We do. Okay, so now
we're like that.
We are like that. So now I'm going to put together some seasonings. So this is a tablespoon of just good quality chili powder. Go with your favorite. I've got a teaspoon of kosher salt, half a teaspoon of black pepper, and we're just going to mix this together right now. And this is going to get added to these vegetables that are sautéing in just a little bit, make it super, super aromatic. Okay, now, Wesley.
All right, so I'm going to mix together some other components of this barbecue sauce.
Man, are you not.
One of the main components is a little ketchup. So I got a cup of ketchup. Let me just get that in there. Yep. And then I've got a half a cup brown sugar.
Mm-hmm.
Then I've got a quarter cup of mustard, just good old French's yellow mustard.
Yellow mustard, whatever brand you've got, but good old yellow mustard.
This is exactly what it is. And then a half a cup of apple cider vinegar.
Those actually were both quarter cups.
No, I meant quarter. Sorry, I said quarter for one of them.
Okay, good.
A quarter and a quarter.
Quarter and a quarter.
And then I've got 3 tablespoons of Worcestershire sauce.
You got to say it just like that.
2 tablespoons of molasses.
Yum. All the classic components of BBQ sauce.
Yes, look at that. That's just nice and smooth.
It's already smelling yummy.
And then I've got 2 tablespoons of lemon juice.
Delicious, fresh.
All right,
is best.
Now we're gonna add a little sweetness besides the molasses. Actually, molasses is not that sweet.
It's got a little sweetness too.
It's a little tangy for me. Anyway, all right, we've got some honey. And we're gonna put
reach for it. Stretch
2 tablespoons of honey in
He's
there.
Eyeballing it, folks.
I'm eyeballing it. One more squirt there.
I can tell you when you make this, if you're gonna dole everything out like we have, you're probably gonna need to go pick up some extra bowls.
Totally, we're using every bowl
in the house. And while you're doing that, I'm gonna put in 2 cloves of garlic that I have minced.
Awesome, and then I've got some steak sauce. I'm gonna do 2 tablespoons of steak sauce. We're using A1.
Just whatever you've got on hand.
There we go.
I don't ever use steak sauce except when I'm making this barbecue sauce.
And then some hot sauce. This we're gonna use. There we go.
Not that hot. A couple of dashes.
And I'm just going to mix this all together.
Okay, that's great. Now, while you're doing that, so this has been going, these have gotten nice and softened. I'm going to add this.
I'm going to stand back here when I do this.
Spice blend, yeah. Nice.
Is that what you just mixed together in that bowl?
Yes, that's what I just mixed together. Okay. It's going to coat those onions. Oh, the smell. I love this smell.
I always get, if it's balsamic vinegar, barbecue sauce, it's always on my shirt.
You might want to wear an apron when you're doing this because it does get a little sloshy. All right, I'm going to clear some of
it.
It's a culinary word. You know what we mean by that.
Yes, I do.
Okay.
All right. Now, when do you get this? Just a little bit?
Yeah, right now.
Oh, all right.
Now, just be careful when we're pouring. If you want to pour it in, pour it in nice and slow. It shouldn't be too splattery.
Use this setup.
It's another culinary term, splattery.
Sloshy and splattery.
Sloshy and splattery.
Ready?
Yep. Ah, yes.
Oh, there we go.
That smell.
Wow.
I could not imagine. I mean, in Texas, barbecue sauce, most barbecue is not heavily sauced. Just as a little side note, but I love good old quality barbecue sauce. I think a lot of Texans do too. They always have it on the side and they get it.
Yeah, you are. You use a lot of barbecue sauce when you're eating your ribs.
Oh, and you don't.
I know.
All right, let's talk shrimp.
All right, we have got a pound of large shrimp. Actually, I think they're jumbo or they're extra large.
They're extra large. I was trying to find some colossal. If you can get your hands on some good Gulf shrimp off the Gulf, off of the shores of Louisiana.
Is that where the Gulf is?
Is, yes, yes. They are, I think, the best.
They are.
But anyway, I got some extra large shrimp that we deveined and we took the shells off, although we left the tails on.
Yes, just because it's they look pretty and you can have something to grab onto.
That's
when
right.
You're dunking them in that barbecue sauce.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so I've got the pound of shrimp and I've got a tablespoon of some Cajun seasoning, speaking of Gulf.
Yeah.
There we go.
Or sometimes you see it, it's Creole seasoning. If you're in a location, you can't find it. I have a recipe on how you can make your own.
It's so good.
In the blog post, it's really
so good. And then I've got 2 tablespoons of olive oil, and I'm just gonna mix these all together so they can get nice and coated. Wow.
Oh, it's gonna be so good.
This
is such
delicious.
A simple recipe, and what is great about it is you can obviously make this barbecue sauce like up to a week.
Yes.
So then it's just a matter of all you do is you do that. We're gonna let that sit.
Yeah.
In the
and this has got some salt in it, so we're not gonna put any.
Yeah,
extra
you don't
salt
need to. But that's true. That's a good point. The most Cajun seasonings have a decent amount of salt, so you don't need to add any more seasonings. You could also just salt and pepper them if you don't want to do the Cajun, but the Cajun adds a little.
Yes.
Flavor.
We love that.
How's it looking?
That looks great.
That's
right.
Perfect.
So we're gonna let this sit here and meld for about an hour. So I'll put it in the fridge. And
we're gonna
let this cool.
I'm just gonna let this simmer for about 10 more minutes, and then you can leave the onions in there if you want. I kind of like a smooth barbecue sauce, so we're gonna strain it. And while that's cooling, this will cool. Then it's time to grill. Okay,
yay!
We are moving right along. We've got our beautiful, the barbecue sauce smells so good.
Smells so good.
Well, like I said, we let it simmer just for about 10, 15 minutes, just to get those flavors really melded. And then I got a strainer. You can let it cool for a minute if you want, just so it's easier to handle. And then you just strain that into a heat-proof bowl and use a spatula just to kind of get it all the way through. And then
let it cool down.
So what you want to let it cool down. This has been in there for about an hour. So you definitely want to remember, this is important. So you're going to separate. The barbecue sauce, what we did by having the recipe, makes about 3 cups. So you want to divide it, because this is what we're going to baste the shrimp with. And then once we're done doing that, you're going to have to discard it because it's going to be on raw shrimp. So you don't want to eat that.
No.
So make sure you say, I've got probably 2 cups here, and then I got a cup here, because you're going to want to have more for plunging and dipping and all that sort of fun stuff. So now what we are going to do is we are going to skewer. So we've got some fun metal skewers here. I have a link to these in the description. If you don't have metal skewers, no problem. If you're using wooden, I would recommend soaking them in water for about 30 minutes, because you don't want them to catch on fire when you're out at the body.
So there we go.
Yeah. And then so we
like to do a double skewer through it, through the tail and then through the larger part.
Yeah, it just keeps it
just
in place.
Just stay like that. And then we're going to put, I think we counted these as 5, 5, and 6 or something.
Yeah, just
like
kind of evenly distribute
all
them.
All right. Oh, yay!
Boy, these shrimpies are getting excited.
They are.
I'm not as excited as we are. Okay, so we have cranked up our grill. We're going to discard of our shrimpy gloves.
Here we go. No. Oh, see, yeah, get rid of my gloves. Thank you. Look at those. Those are ready for the barbie.
So we've got you want to fire your grill up to like a nice medium hot grill. We're going to go and do these on direct heat. It doesn't take long to cook these at all. And then we're going to baste them out there. So
grab that. I'll grab the shrimp.
We'll see you at the barbie.
Yay. hot out there.
We almost didn't need the grill.
We always do it on the hottest days.
So it's so fantastic. Look at that. Is that not a
gorgeous?
So, you know, however you're doing it, there can be a little tricky to turn. I find the best way is I've got my heat-proof gloves, but you can get a pair of tongs. Just be careful. You got hot ashes out there. But they only went about 3 minutes per side.
Oh, put and, a little bit more on there,
oh, yeah, please. Yeah. You're exactly right. How good. And we divvied up our barbecue sauce amongst...
Yes. We each have our own little barbecue.
So everyone has their own little individual. So who cares if you double dip? You got your own batch of barbecue sauce. And always a little extra is always so good.
Yeah.
I am so salivating right now. You guys, if you could smell this.
Is that hot?
It's a little hot, yeah.
Yeah.
These skewers do cool off pretty quick.
All right, here, I've got the fork. Just bring the skewer over, and I will empty it onto there. There we go. Here we go.
Yeah, just go for it.
Pull it. Oh, there we go. Chris, hold on. There we go. Sorry. Hold on, people.
We rehearsed this, I promise. Oh, my goodness gracious.
Make sure everybody can see that wonderfulness. Oh. Wow. I think that I'm going to... Oh, look at that, Chris.
Yeah. That is something to behold. I am so excited.
Here's your dipping.
My dipping. I love my dipping sauce.
Make sure you got napkins, paper towels, whatever's handy.
This is barbecue perfection.
This is. Look
well, that. We haven't had it yet, so.
Look at that, you guys. Look at that. Mm. That is something that.
You can do a little plungy. I mean, you know, why not?
Ready?
Yes. That, folks.
Mm.
You serve that at your next barbecue.
Oh.
He's not even that big of a fan of shrimp. He likes it. But how do you think about this?
Oh, that seasoning?
Yeah.
Holy! And a little heat.
You get the little...
And then the sweetness and the tangy.
And the smoke from that the grill.
The sweetness and the tanginess of the barbecue sauce.
That's legendary.
I'm gonna have one more.
Your silence. When you serve something and you hear silence, that's usually a good thing. And then followed by a dance.
I'm marching right to the Gulf to get me some more shrimp. Wow, y'all. You need to make this because it's easy and it's delicious. And it's 100,000% lube proof.
Oh my goodness.
I never give that to fish.
You don't. That shows you how good it is. You guys.
I can't stop eating it.
I know, ooh. I know. So it's so much fun. It's a celebration of deliciousness. Mm. Barbecue is the way to go. And shrimp it.
Wow.
All right, everybody. We love you so much.
Mm.
Shrimp.
Mega.